Hi there, Teek here. Today, I'm going to teach you how to write a best-selling novel. Now, I've never written a best-selling novel before, but how hard could it be? So these are my 7 tips to writing a really good novel. Now, I'm not going to treat you like an idiot and baby you by numbering each step. I think you're smart enough to figure that out. Plus, I didn't really number these yet. In fact, I'm making this up as I go, which is step number 1. Don't have a plan, just write. Just make it up as you go. Step number 2, have a plan. Plot it out, write the story. Yeah. Step number 3. Wait, I said I wasn't going to do that. All right. Well, let's talk about some things that every good story has. Obviously, there's a beginning, a middle, an end, and an iconic John Williams score. A lot of stories say you should start with an introduction, then go to the rising action, the climax, falling action, and so forth, the resolution. I say just start in the middle of the action. Then if you need to introduce characters, do that afterwards. Most important thing you want to focus on is character. Unless you're doing a plot-driven story instead of a character-driven story, in which case the characters don't matter that much. But if you want a character-driven story, I'd say you go with either a strong female lead or a whiny male lead. Also, they should probably have no connection to their parents whatsoever. Unless you're doing a Hallmark film, then you're allowed one parent. And if your story does happen to have both parents around, make them like mortal enemies with the child. It's the best way to go. You know, just for once, I'd like to see a story where like there's a father Jedi and a son Jedi, and they work together, and then while we're throwing in twists and changes, the stormtroopers come in and win at the end. I think that would be a great story. If we're going to get into writing a good story, you need to make sure that you don't infringe on any copyrighted material. You can't go out and write a Star Wars book and publish and sell it without the proper authorization. So if you have any ideas to do that, I'd just say move along. That doesn't mean you can't totally rip off ideas and call it something else. For instance, my story is not about a stormtrooper. It's about a guy who wears white armor and maybe a helmet and black gloves. And nice white boots. Not a stormtrooper. All right, let's get into this. Let's turn our attention to the computer. All right, if you look here, I got a blank document. And it's important, this much I do know, don't use the font that it defaults with unless you've changed the default to something a lot better. I mean, you could do Times New Roman. That's usually a pretty safe bet. Don't do Calibri or whatever it's called. Don't do Comic Sans. Don't do Wingdings or crazy cursive fonts that you can't tell. In this one, I've decided to go with the like a script style font. But I'm not writing a script. I'm writing a novel. In this one, it's a strong male protagonist. And if you ever have trouble with protagonist and antagonist, just think pro is like the professional good guy. And the antagonist is antagonist. He's bad. Alright. Let's do this. Alright. So this character's name is, let's see, oh. Teek. Oh boy. This is going to take a while. There's only supposed to be one E. There are some limitations to being a stormtrooper. One, you can't see. And two, you can't seem to aim properly and hit the right keys. I get it. Oh. All right, I'll leave it to my editor. Teak is awesome. Oh boy. This is gonna take a long time. He never misses. I promise you, I can spell. It is required at the academy. They also let us do it without these helmets. Those are basic tips to writing a good story. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you go out there and write your novels. And in about 25 years, hopefully sooner, I hope you consider buying mine. All right. Have a great day. Teak out.